In oligohydraminoes, oligo means less, and hydraminoes refer to the amniotic fluid. So, oligohydraminoes is a condition in which the amniotic fluid decreases, or which, on ultrasound, amniotic fluid index is less than 5th centile of gestational age, and the maximum vertical pocket of the amniotic fluid measures less than 2 cm. As the amniotic fluid is produced mainly by the fetal urinary system, so any blockage in its path or the urinary pathology like the renal agenesis, polycystic kidney disease, urethral obstruction, or the amniotic fluid loss, for example, which occurs in the premature ruptured membranes, causes the oligohydraminoes. Besides, the maternal NSAIDs use also leads to the same problem. On examination, the symphysiofundal height is less than the gestational age. The baby would be in hyperflexion or it would be malpresented. The fetal parts would be difficult to define. Similarly, the fetal heart sounds are difficult to hear. Ultrasound is the investigation of choice for oligohydraminoes. Empty bladder or no renal tissue is found in the renal agenesis. Cysts are found in polycystic kidney disease. A distended pelvis, ureter, and bladder is found in a posterior urethral valve. Besides, baseline investigation are also performed. Management depends upon the condition of the fetus and the gestational age. If the female presents at term or with a malformed baby, IUD or IUGR, she is delivered as soon as possible. If the female presents with a normal baby before the term, then amniotic fluid is increased by several methods. These include antenatal vesicoamniotic shunting in the obstructive uropathies, serial transabdominal aminotransfusions, which is started after the 20 weeks. Normal saline can also be infused transcervically. Maternal IV fluids can also be given. Fibrinogen is also used in some condition for the cervical occlusion. As in the oligohydraminoes, adhesions are formed within the amniotic cavity. This leads to the amniotic band syndrome, which encircles around the fetal rim or the digit, leading to amputation. As the baby swallows the amniotic fluid, so oligohydraminoes leads to the pulmonary hypoplasia. Amniotic fluid acts as a cushion between the fetus and the uterine wall. So, its decreased amount leads to a pressure effect like the hip dislocation, talipes equinovarus, Potter syndrome, limb contracture, and scoliosis. If you like our videos, like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, click the bell icon to get the latest updates. You can also follow us on the Facebook at Dr. Sain's official page. Thank you for watching.